Payne, Unfold, and Wade. We just received some breaking news during the commercial break. Make sure you are subscribed and following WWE's social platforms for a major announcement tomorrow, covered by Rezar. Tyler Bate stays alive.
Yeah, I've been hearing rumors all day about that announcement coming tomorrow. I'm excited to see what is fact, what is fiction. Cannot wait for that tomorrow, but I'll tell you something that is absolute fact. That is that AOP are two bad, bad dudes, and Tyler Bate is in a hell of a lot of trouble.
AOP have managed to cut the ring in half and isolate Bate from his partner, Pete Dunne. Think of how bad this has got to feel if you're Tyler Bate, seeing that Pete Dunne, that your last hope is only a few feet away as Rezar squeezes every last breath out of your broken body.
Dunne and Bate felt completely humiliated by last week's needless attack from the Final Testament. Tonight is about showing the world that they don't back down from anyone, but that is easier said than done.
Look at Tyler Bate trying to slide his way out of the bear hug, manages to do so, but might have found himself in an even less favorable position. Dropkick created some separation. Can Bate make the tag?
Thrown up in the air with ease.
Rezar just too quick, able to close the distance.
That's really the impressive thing about AOP, that unfathomable speed for two massive guys like that, and Tyler Bate fighting for dear life. And that might do it, Corey.
Tyler Bate has daylight. The cruiserweight is jonesing to join the fight.
You've got an opportunity. You won't get another. You don't need another. Here's Dunne.
Pete Dunne has been unleashed in this one. Big dropkick takes down Rezar, and the cruiserweight striking anything that moves.
Simply nobody in the locker room who can go from casual indifference to rabid rage in the blink of an eye, quite like Pete Dunne.
Sliced bread cover here.
Paul Ellering on the outside now has fear in his eyes. It's not often you see that.
The cruiserweight making the climb to the top turnbuckle yet again. Here comes Dunne. Tremendous athleticism, able to adjust midair. Here comes Bate, who's legal.
Bate's got his second win in a hurry.
A barrage of strikes from the New Catch Republic, and can he do it? Yes, he can! The big, strong boy! I've seen it with my own two eyes, and I don't believe it.
My lower back hurt watching that, you ludicrous human being, Tyler Bate.
Shooting star by Bate. Running knee by Dunne. Hook of the leg. Here comes Akam to break up the fall.
Split second away from what many would have down as a shock victory.
Looking to take out both members of the NCR, but oh no. That's small joint manipulation. A pair of forearms sends Rezar to the outside, to the feet of Scarlett. New Catch Republic are rolling, Wade.
And all the wind in the sails.
This wicked siren, Scarlett, making her presence known and done. Takes out Rezar on the outside.
Tyler Bate using his body as a missile.
Uh-oh. Oh, my God. Karrion Kross just flattened Tyler Bate. Pete Dunne takes out Kross. And a standing uranagi by Rezar. This could be the beginning of the end.
A distraction by Scarlett and Karrion Kross leads to this. Devastation.
Here are your winners, Authors of Pain!
A strong final showing on Friday Night SmackDown for the Final Testament. Monday Night Raw. Grit your teeth. This matchup was back and forth, both teams pulling out all the stops. Tyler Bate sacrificing his own safety.
This is when the referee's back was turned clearly. Karrion Kross taking his opportunity to flatten Tyler Bate before getting one in return from Pete Dunne, who that momentary distraction opened the door for Akam with a uranage before once again perhaps the most devastating move in the tag division. Victory for AOP. They move onwards and upwards.
Monday Night Raw certainly in for a heavy dose of sadism, courtesy of the Final Testament. Another group that we expected to be drafted much earlier last week, Wade, was the Bloodline. But last week, more than worrying about their draft stock, the Bloodline had their hands full with an irate Kevin Owens.
Yeah, well, two.